Good afternoon, all of you. Today, we are going to start with a discussion on Unit 6, a small poem, class discussion. It's a very short poem. So let's go and check what's there in this poem. So it's a very small poem. You have to recite it and discuss about the poem. Class discussion. In the class discussion, Jane, you hardly said a word. We all aired our opinions, but from you we barely heard. You sat and stared in silence, surrounded by the chatter. Now tell me, Jane, and please be plain. Is there anything the matter? Jane looked up and then she spoke. Her voice was clear and low. There are many people in this world who are rather quiet, you know. By Gervase Finn. So, if you look at the first paragraph of the poem. In the class discussion, Jane, you hardly said a word. So, the teacher is asking a small girl. The girl is named as Jane. So, the teacher is asking the Jane. Teacher is asking Jane, in the class discussion, they had conducted a class discussion and Jane did not speak a word. Hardly she spoke a word. She did not speak at all. We all aired our opinions, but from you we barely heard. We all made our opinions public. All the other children, okay, including the teacher, they all what they did. They were making whatever is in their mind. Okay, they were shouting loudly. They were allowed. Everyone was participating. But Jane was not able to speak anything. You sat and stared in silence surrounded by the chatter. So Jane sat silently and everyone was speaking. Now tell me, Jane. And please be plain. Tell me and be clear. Is there anything the matter? Is there any problem you are facing? That's why you are not speaking. Any problem is there? So, next. Jane looked up and then she spoke. So, Jane is looking up and she is telling. Her voice was clear and low. Her voice was very clear. Her sound was very low, but voice was very clear. There are many people in this world who are rather quiet, you know. She's saying that there are many people in this world who are very quiet. Okay. So, this is a very simple poem. Okay. So, just let us look at the meanings of this poem. Right. Let us move towards the meanings. So, the first word, discussion. So, we have a class discussion, right? All of you have participated in the class discussion. So, like that, discussions are there. Many discussions are there. In families, there are discussion. Okay, in many, many places, there are discussions. So, discussion is talking together in a group on a single topic. So, many people, two or three friends, sometimes we discuss on a single topic. Right? So, that is called as a discussion. Aired. Aired means make public. Okay, whatever is there, you have to open your mouth and say it loud. That is make it public. Barely means only just. Okay. Stare. Look fixedly with eyes wide open. We studied this word stare. Right. Stare where we studied. We studied in the poem Lazy Frog. Right. We studied this word. So plain. Plain means clear. Okay. Plain means clear. In a plain voice, clear voice, okay, and loudly she spoke. Jane is speaking, okay, loud and clear voice. Let us discuss the question answers. What activity was going on in the class? So, what was the activity? Discussion. It was a class discussion. Discussion was going on in the class. Who was the quiet one in the class? So, who was quiet? All of you know. Jane was the quiet one in the class. Why was she quiet? four reasons have been given. You have to select the correct option. She was afraid to air her opinions. She hated the noise. She didn't like the activity. She was quiet by nature. So at the end of the poem, it's already told that she was quiet by nature. How do you interact in class during discussions? Do you participate or remain quiet? So what is your opinion? You have to write there. Okay, maybe I speak less but listen to others more. Or maybe I speak, right? Along with that, I write. Okay, I suggest my opinions. So you can write how you are in the class depending upon yourself. Okay. Now, choose two friends in your class who are very different from each other. Use the clues in the box to describe their nature. You may also add your own words to describe them. Naughty, lively, sharing, careless, studious, quiet, friendly, helpful, regular, cheerful. So one answer is suggested over here, but don't write the same answer. You have to write your own answer. Okay. Munni and Sonu are my classmates. They both are different by nature. Sonu is lively and naughty. Lively and naughty means who are very active in the class. Okay. He is helpful and very friendly. Munni is a quiet boy. He is very studious. He is very regular in his studies. But Sonu is not cheerful as Munni. Everybody likes Sonu. So you can use the words and you can make your own answer. Right? Moving further. Page number 97 of your textbook. What is a discussion? So what is a discussion? To discuss means to talk together or decide something. When you do this, you are taking part in a discussion. So when friends come together, we discuss something, right? About our old books, about our old friends, maybe our teachers. Okay, all these things we discuss. Maybe some storybook, right? Maybe somebody's birthday celebration. So all these things we discuss. Now, read the sentences below. They tell us what happened in a discussion. So what are the things that happen in a discussion? In a discussion, each person gives his ideas one by one. So when a class discussion is going on, every person gives his ideas one by one. Some tell why something should be done. Others may tell how. Okay. Suppose there is a discussion about the birthday party. Then everybody says, one will say, I will bring the cake. Other will say, I'll bring the candle. Then other will say that we will celebrate our friend's birthday over here. Okay, then I'll bring balloons. So like that, everyone takes the part. Okay, and somebody tells that why we are doing this, why we should bring the cake. Okay, because for birthday celebration we need the cake. Then others will tell how do we cut the cake, how do we blow the candle, when do we do it, all these. Okay, so participants ask question and answer them. Questions and answer them. So if some child is asking, okay, how will we bring the cake? From where will we bring the cake? Okay, then the other person from that group itself can answer that we will bring the cake from bakery, or we'll bake it at home, or my mother will make the cake and we all will eat it together. So like that, discussions, right? Many ideas are given and everyone helped to decide which ideas are the best. So different people will say different ideas, right? For the birthday celebration, one will say I'll bake the cake and bring it. Other will say that my mother will give it from home. Third will say we'll purchase it from the bakery. Okay, so like that. So all are sitting together. Then one person will say that you are bringing from the cake from the home, that will be best. Your mother's cake is very tasty, right? Like that we give our opinions. So like that we can discuss. So in a discussion, a person gives his ideas one by one. Some tell why something should be done. Others tell how. Participants ask questions and answer them. Many ideas. We get many ideas from a discussion. And everyone helps to decide which is the best idea. Note the points you might discuss before planning a visit to a park. Suppose you are visiting a park, then what do? You discuss with your friends, right? You choose a day and time. First, you choose a day and time. One will say, we'll go tomorrow. Other will say, tomorrow I'm not free, so we'll go day after tomorrow. So like that, somehow you will get a day and time when everyone is free. What things to bring to play? When you are going to the park, you need to play, right? So what things will play? One will bring a football. Then other will say that I will bring a skipping rope. So all these things. Assigned duties. Okay. In school, when we are going for a tour, we assign the duties, right? Things to eat. Okay. So these are things. Now look at the pictures in the poem. Imagine and write what the discussion in the class is about. So you have to look at the picture in the poem and you can think about what the, if you see the picture, you can get an idea of what the class discussion was. Okay. So just what idea it may be, you think and you tell me in the online class. Question number 2. Fill in the grid given below by assigning qualities to each person. Some clues are given here to help you. Some clues are there. Sangeeta lends her pencil to her partner. Nirav is also called a chatterbox. Pranav recently saved a cat from drowning in the lake. Megha is just the opposite of Nirav. Mithila always teases everyone. Ritu is always seen with a book in hand. So if you fill the grid, Pranav, okay, what is told about Pranav? Pranav recently saved a cat from drowning in the lake. So he is brave. Nirav, what is told about Nirav? Nirav is also called a chatterbox. Chatterbox because he always talks. Okay, so like that you can see the characters and you can fill in the table in your textbook. Now, children who show exceptional bravery are honored with the Bravery Award to recognize their presence of mind. In 1957, the Indian Council of Child Welfare started these National Bravery Awards. So every year, National Bravery Award is given. We are talking about this. Okay. So brave children are awarded cash prizes, free school education, and a certificate from the Prime Minister of India. They ride on an elephant in the Republic Day parade. This year we did not have this. Okay. Harsh Srivastava, a 12-year-old boy and his 15-year-old sister rescued a child from the attack of a raging bull. Yumnan Jayadev Singh, 11 years old, jumped into the flooded river and saved a 3-year-old from drowning. The act of bravery was recognized because he saved the life of an infant. Find one story of bravery about a child. You can search for the story by talking to older people or watching a TV program or from a film. Write down the story. Also mention its source. Narrate the story to the class. Which story did you like the best? Write down your reasons. So similarly, you can write a bravery story. And you have to mention from which source you got that. Okay. Now, read Sheila's notice. Discuss the questions that follow. Notice. The drama committee will meet in the classroom on Monday at 2 o'clock. We'll plan a play for our annual day. Will each one of you please bring a play? Right. So, this is the notice. So, we have to read the notice. The notice, it's mentioned that the drama committee will meet in the classroom. They will have a meeting in the classroom on Monday at 2 o'clock. Okay. So notice is giving a short idea. It gives us a short idea about the programs that are going on. Okay. And what the programs we need to plan. Okay. So we'll plan a play for our annual day. Will each one of you please bring a play? So everyone has to bring a play when they are coming for the discussion. Drama discussion. So now, depending upon the notice, let us try to answer the following questions. Who was to meet? The drama committee was to meet. When were they to meet? They were to meet on Monday at 2 o'clock. Where were they to meet? They were to meet in the classroom. What were they to do? They were to plan a play for their annual day. Now, you have to write a notice about library committee or a football match. The notice which I have given is just for your understanding. Please don't copy this notice. Okay, you have to make your own notice. So just look at the notice. An inter-school football match will be played between DAV Public School and our school at Mars Stadium. The match will be held on 5th February at 2 p.m. All the students are requested to visit the stadium and watch the match. Saurav. Similarly, you also have to prepare a short notice. With this, we are ending today's class and waiting for you in the online class. Thank you.